各位
现场和线上的嘉宾们，大家下午好，
Distinguished guests,
我是来自
good
Huawei
afternoon.
广播产品部的毛旭啊，
I am Mao
非常感谢
Xu
各位莅临和参加
Hybrid Cloud Product Line.
2020
Thank you so much for attending Huawei Connect 2020 Huawei Cloud Stack session on a brand new architecture for intelligent transformation. Based on rich industry practices and Huawei's own digital experience, Huawei Cloud Stack, with Huawei Cloud Services at its core, is dedicated to building one cloud from the user perspective for large governments and enterprises and accelerating their roads to intelligence. The first speaker today is Mr. Gu Zhong, Chief Architect of Huawei Hybrid Cloud. He will introduce how Huawei Cloud Stack supports and accelerates the migration of mission-critical government and enterprise services to the cloud from four dimensions: experience, efficiency, reliability, and O&M. Let's welcome Mr. Gu. Distinguished guests, first a brief self-introduction. I'm Gu Zhong from Huawei Hybrid Cloud. I attended Huawei Connect many times, but this is the first time I attend this conference as a Huawei employee. In the past, I worked in one of the telecom carriers for 10 years, and I helped the carrier to migrate many of their services onto the cloud. For example, we migrated the core services on the cloud. At the same time, we are now working with ICBC to digitalize their company. We built five financial clouds, and I work as a chief architect in that project. In the intelligent upgrade of enterprises, we have summarized four key elements in helping the enterprises to migrate to the cloud: custom experience, efficiency, reliability, and ease of O&M. In traditional virtualization, we only solved the resource utilization issue. After migrating the mission-critical applications onto the cloud, for the virtual machine, solving the virtual machine issues is not enough. We haven't been able to enjoy the benefits of the cloud migration. A few days ago, I saw a news. Some people are saying that Huawei is an internet company. However, I think Huawei is a traditional IT company. Why is that? Because from 2015, Huawei's BPIT started to do digital transformation and intelligent upgrade. Today's sharing will be based on my own experience and Huawei's BPIT's experience in digital transformation. As we all know, Huawei is a global company. We have customers in different industries. We have billions of consumers, to-be customers, and also internal Huawei employees who are staying at different countries around the world. How to improve the experience of the user is very important, and the key is the distance. The long distance brings big challenges to us. How could we enhance the user experience of our applications? We have the 3 plus 12 plus 26 architecture. We have the central cloud, the edge cloud, and Huawei Cloud Stack. This is the 3 plus 12 plus 62 hybrid cloud architecture. In the southern, northern, eastern, and western part of China, we have established regions with 12 milliseconds of latency. And we also have 62 edge nodes. We also have 12 data centers globally with 100 milliseconds latency. In this architecture, Huawei's BPIT is building a unified cloud from the user perspective, which is connecting resources around the world and provide better application experience. So how did we manage global resources in a unified manner? Huawei has the Qingtian architecture, which provides intelligent and high-efficient foundation for intelligent scheduling. and integration of hardware and software capabilities. It can provide diverse computing power, stable, reliable, highly available, and secure foundation. So Huawei's hybrid cloud has an architecture of device, edge, and cloud. And this hybrid cloud architecture helped us to flexibly deploy applications on the cloud. In the enterprise IT, 79% of the to-B businesses have already been deployed on Huawei Cloud in the 12 regions around the world. And Huawei's core to-B businesses have been deployed on Huawei Cloud Stack, so that we can enjoy elastic cloud resources and agile services, and we can also stay closer to our users and also protect the data sovereignty of the company while migrating the mission-critical applications on our own cloud. In this architecture, there are certain issues. A few days ago, one of our customers was discussing with us about one issue. Now we have cloud migration, but we're mainly using the VM features. We haven't been able to bring into full play many other functions. Huawei is traditionally an IT company for 30 plus years. Many of our capabilities need to be represented on the cloud. So we have the service builder, which can present the IT capabilities accumulated to the service applications so that they can apply for them flexibly and use them quickly. The flexible services are built on the IaaS, PaaS, and Big Data Foundation. Huawei's BPIT has encapsulated our IT capabilities and orchestrate the management processes and other IT processes so as to present brand new cloud services to our users. This is like a secondary encapsulation of traditional IT services. For example, we could leverage the database capabilities. In the past, we needed to apply for VM and then deploy the VM. We haven't been able to provide service-oriented capabilities, but with the service builder, we can integrate these capabilities. Inside Huawei, we have already encapsulated 10 types of capabilities, including intelligent O&M, big security capabilities, and so on. With the integration of these capabilities, migration of mission-critical applications to the cloud will be easier. The migration is not only about VM, but more importantly about the IT capabilities we have accumulated. I talked about the 3+12 architecture. When it comes to high availability of applications, Huawei built the dual-redundant DR architecture with two sites and three centers. We have helped many financial institutions in building the two sites and three centers. Now I want to clarify one concept to you. Many of you believe that active and multi-active are quite different from each other. Active and active data centers are built in the same center and realized through a level 2 network or layer 2 network. The RTO and RPO could be very low. For multi-active deployment, it could be deployed in the same city, but with distributed capabilities, we can develop multi-active capabilities in different locations. In China and around the world, through the distributed architecture, we can achieve multi-active deployment. We can support both active and active and multi-active deployment. And we can also combine them too for active-active deployment of applications and multi-active capabilities outside of that, so as to improve the security of mission-critical applications. And this will make sure that the mission-critical applications will always be available on the cloud. And our digital capabilities will help us to drive down the RPO to zero in case of failover. After migrating the applications on the cloud, the applications will become more complex because of the distributed architecture we are using. In IaaS, PaaS, and SaaS, we have many tools, both open source and non-open source tools. In our daily work, we may encounter faults every day. What is more scary is the major fault that happens once or twice every year, which will take a long time for troubleshooting. Despite the tools we have, we do not have the capability to map the tools to our equipment and our network. In Huawei's BPIT, we have the relationship between the application layer, virtual infrastructure layer, and physical infrastructure layer. And with AI and big data analytics, we integrate the three layers. And once faults occur, we can quickly locate the faults. And with the accumulation of our capabilities, we can quickly call the right tools to resolve the issues. With the tools, 90% of the commands can be automated within Huawei's BPIT, and 90% of the major faults could be solved within 30 minutes. And this is about the AI applications. AI is a key driving force for moving mission-critical applications of governments and enterprises onto the cloud. Here we have the level nozzle, which is one promoter in the rocket, and it can increase the speed of the rocket to supersonic level. And I compare our AI applications to this level nozzle. For any intelligent application, we need to conduct training and inference. With our applications, we can quickly train and develop these applications. I can give a simple example. Huawei's reimbursement system was quite convenient, but in the past, I needed to take photos of each invoice, and I need to input the invoice amount and the tax number into the system one by one. But now, I just need to take one photo, and everything else is done automatically. And then I realized that in 2020, we have developed many AI applications, and it's like Huawei having 7,300 digital employees in 2020 to handle the repetitive tasks. And this will improve the experience and make mission-critical applications more intelligent. This is only a simple example. and these AI applications have been widely applied in the mining industry and in the petroleum industry as well. Huawei has had our technological accumulations in these areas. And these service builder can turn these into services so that our users can use them in a convenient way. I just shared with you the experience of Huawei's BPIT. Huawei's cloud, Huawei's BPIT intends to build a unified cloud from the user perspective by integrating Huawei Cloud and Huawei Cloud Stack. The Qingtian architecture is leveraged to provide an intelligent and efficient cloud foundation for mission-critical applications. And the unique service builder we provide can make it easier to migrate mission-critical applications to the cloud. At the same time, with our geo-redundant DR architecture, the mission-critical applications will always be available on the cloud. And intelligent OIM helps to safeguard mission-critical applications on the cloud. And our AI can make applications more intelligent and bring better experience. Based on Huawei's own digital transformation experience, we will accumulate this experience in Huawei Cloud Stack and help customers in their digital transformation and intelligent upgrade. Huawei has already served over 150 countries, over 550 e-government clouds, and over 200 financial clouds. We will continue to move forward and help enterprises in their digital transformation. That's all for my sharing today. Thank you so much. Thank you, Mr. Gu, for your in-depth analysis, which helps us clearly understand how Huawei Cloud Stack supports the migration of core government and enterprise services to the cloud. As mentioned earlier, Huawei Cloud Stack has served more than 4,000 customers and more than 550 e-government cloud customers worldwide. We wouldn't be successful without the support of our customers. Next, let's welcome Mr. Sun Fei, Deputy Director of Shenzhen Big Data Resource Management Center, to introduce how Shenzhen advances smart city with Huawei Cloud Stack.
Good afternoon, friends and online viewers. I'm very honored to be here to attend Huawei Connect 2020. I am Sun Fei from Shenzhen Big Data Resource Management Center. And my topic today is Shenzhen advances a smart city with Huawei Cloud Stack. As we know, this year marks the 40th anniversary of Shenzhen's establishment of Shenzhen Municipality. Shenzhen as the leader that forged ahead in reform and opening up efforts of the central government eventually turns a fishing village into a modern city, creating a miracle of in the field of economics and also growth. Now it's the only city of the top five in the world, next to New York, Los Angeles, Singapore, and London in the world as the most prosperous cities. And its future goal is to be a city with a strong competitiveness and influence and impact and as a benchmark city in the world. Opportunities and challenges come together. The past year witnessed a lot of tremendous challenges and opportunities, and also created opportunity for digital transformation for us. We have seen a wave on its way for digital transformation in the field of government affairs. Thanks to the establishment of Yuegang or Bay Area and also the pilot projects launched by the central government in Guangdong province, thanks to the guidelines and policies released by the central government in improving the livelihood of common people in China. And also with the help of big data, AI technology and advanced technologies of such kind, Shenzhen, despite its shortcomings and problems in population growth, traffic, etc., is still growing strong. What is the future of Shenzhen like for many people like us, for citizens of Shenzhen? Their pursuit has already shifted from material life to a happy life featuring security and safety and convenience. For instance, they are wondering how to improve their life via technology, how to enjoy government services using intelligent technologies. The operation of businesses, enterprises are changing their mindsets, how to tap into their own strength, how to integrate their businesses into the entire industrial chain, how to realize common prosperity for everyone. For Shenzhen, the city is seeking ways to be more efficient, more secure and safe, and provide its citizens with more reliable and safe and intelligent services. At this year's CPC Congress session of Shenzhen, the local government made a roadmap, a blueprint for Shenzhen's future development. We hope that in the next decade, we are going to be a world leader in smart city progress. And we are going to build Shenzhen into a city of intelligence and convenience. And we are advancing to the areas in that of public affairs and realize intelligent transformation in these aspects. For this purpose, we need to tap into artificial intelligence, computing technology, infrastructure, and speed up digital transformation and strengthen foundation for technological advancement. We need to use big data and advanced technologies of such kind to provide real-time, immediate, efficient services to the citizens.
那基于以上，我们说华为云 Stack 助力社会真正实现优质的会议体验。For this purpose,
Huawei Cloud Stack provide support to Shenzhen in terms of better governance, better livelihoods, thriving businesses, etc. First, we create one integrated cloud for the city. Second is we create enabler of digital technology. And the third, we create integration platform using digital tools to secure government services, public services performance. And the next, we are going to create a platform using artificial intelligence. And with these efforts, we hope to boost the services of the government to the citizens so as to realize economic prosperity and economic growth. With our technologies, we help the Shenzhen government to finish a lot of innovations in different areas, such as one-stop services and taxation, reimbursement, etc. And all these accomplishments have been have gained the recognition of the citizens and the industries. And these accomplishments have been broadcast by the central broadcasting stations, etc. We also offer support to public hospitals in Shenzhen. 48 public hospitals have already launched online platforms for medical bill reimbursements. And eight such a platform effectively reduces the wait time of the patients and the physical check results and diagnosis results will be released in a more efficient and faster way to the patients. Based on AI technology, we introduce IoT and AI technologies to enable innovations in transportation and lot other areas to speed up the efforts of digitalization in Shenzhen. Next, I'm going to talk about One Unified City Cloud, how we utilize this platform, how we create the AI platform, and how to use these platforms to enable the city to provide better services. The first one is we create One Unified City Cloud. This is the foundation of the smart city. The principles are establishing an economic platform in an economical way, and this is a unified cloud. On this one single cloud, the cloud integrates a lot of enablers, and we signed with the government contracts in establishing Kunpeng Lab to introduce a series of testing and review standards, technological standards. Over 400 government sector services have been migrated to the cloud. And this one single cloud solved the problems of scattered silo performance of government sectors and put them all together in one mechanism. And we have completed this architecture, 1 plus 11 plus n. One is the unified cloud, and 11 is district level e-government cloud platforms. And with this one single cloud, we are able to coordinate all the 11 district level e-commerce cloud platforms. And we utilize the active-active platforms, and we establish the DER centers in different cities. And with these efforts, as Mr. Gu said, we created this geo-redundant system so as to enable the data to be available anytime online. And we, in the future, will use the Shenzhen Center as the logical node for the connect the Greater Bay Area and other model cities in Guangdong province. And the second is we're going to create a big data center for smart city, and this one includes data processing, data collection, and data storage. And this data center will break the data barriers and will enable people to make innovations and manage, conduct management using data so as to increase or improve the city governance level. And now I'm going to talk about four aspects of this big data center. First one is the support layer. The support layer is a storage and computing platform, which is the foundation for safe and reliable performance of the entire cloud. It collects and conglomerates all the data sources and make these data sources into one data bank. And the second layer is designed to solve the silo performance of government sectors. We use unified data lake to help develop data processing. And third layer is data processing. And we set up standards for data processing and also set up the same data banks and assets of such kind to help process data. And we also on this layer, we developed a lot of tools, visualization tools, etc., to help protect the privacy and store data. As for big data center, we use it as a portal to integrate data integration. Internally, we break the data barriers, data silos, to realize data exchange across sectors. Externally, we provide enterprises and government information concerning government services so as to let the public know about the government policies and affairs. And next is application enablement. With years of IT technology development, we have built up large amount of assets of information. Because of the size of such information, we have to deal with cumbersome and clumsiness of such amount of information processing. And so for this purpose, we turn functions into service, and then we provide the service in a very fast fast way. Our this screen is the center of our city governance. It connects 11 districts, 44 sectors, over 110 IT management systems. As an integrated platform, it enables the governance at three levels, so that the administrator of this center is able to get a bird's eye view of the entire city in the fields of city governance, environment protection, etc. And this is an integrated platform driven by data for scientific management of the city.
Fourth, continuous innovation to build the three-level architecture. To achieve the goal of global benchmark cities, we need to look at city management from a higher level and wider perspective. AI is the key to that. Shenzhen works with Huawei to build a unified AI platform and provide unified AI computing power resource pool and gradually launch multi-types of AI services. The unified AI platform uses the city, district, and edge architecture. The city and district levels have their own AI management platforms and AI computing capabilities. Edge computing capabilities meet local video analysis requirements. The regions and edge models are selected in the municipal AI market. The Municipal AI Competence Center can centrally schedule AI service resources in each region. And lastly, is our vision for the future. To continue to build the cornerstone for a smart city, we will improve infrastructure construction and accelerate data aggregation and convergence. First, we will improve 5G network construction and accelerate the deployment and application of 5G in various fields. Second, to accelerate the construction of AI and blockchain capabilities and upgrade basic support platforms so as to provide secure, reliable, intelligent, and efficient software and hardware platform for smart Shenzhen. Third, accelerate data aggregation and interworking, deepen cross-border convergence applications, and for the core industries, we will integrate the new infrastructure with the industries. And based on the leading-edge companies in Shenzhen, we will build showcase scenarios to accelerate the intelligent transformation. Shenzhen is embracing new technologies like 5G, IoT, and AI. We will work closely with Huawei to establish a foundation for a smart city and build better services and better environment for living and work. Everything is connected, everything sensing. This is the future that's waiting for us. Thank you.
好，感谢孙飞主任啊，我们也非常荣幸呢。
Thank you, Mr. Sun Fei.
跟深圳市政府一起去构建万物感知互联网。
We are very honored to work with Shenzhen government in building the Shenzhen Intelligent Twins, featuring all things sensing, all things connected, and all things intelligent. In providing support and improving solutions for our customers, we must work with our partners. Now let's welcome Mr. Yao Ming, manager of Guotai Inpoint Software, to introduce the joint solution of Inpoint and Huawei and how this solution addresses the challenges of cloud migration for governments and enterprises. Distinguished leaders and guests, good afternoon. The first two presentations are quite impressive. Now I'm going to share my presentation with you from the perspective of a partner. How Huawei solution has helped us. I'm very honored to be invited to Huawei Cloud Stack session. Now I'm going to present to you the Guotai Yipun Smart Government solution. With the development of cloud computing, traditional services and applications are moved onto the cloud. But during cloud migration, we are facing various challenges. With the unified e-government platform and the efforts on building digital government, we have moved from the fragmented construction to intensive construction. Against this, the benefit is that we can fully leverage the investment, but the intensive construction will result in an explosion of service data. I can share one example with you. I'm from Zhangjiagang. In that city, we had cooperation with Huawei as well. Zhangjiagang is a county-level city. Starting from last year, the municipal government started to build the unified work platform, connecting all the lower level governments. And the estimated user is around 30,000, much, much more than the number of users we had in the past. And the e-government cloud is running government services that are critical for people's livelihood. I've been through one case due to the huge workload in the data center. Since there is no reliability solution, the DC broke down for around 3 hours. And the e-government platform and websites and service centers suffer from outages for a few hours, resulting in complaints from the users. And faced with the complexity of international situation, it is more important for us to master the core technologies. But during this, enterprises and governments are faced with a choice. We need to communicate with the Chinese suppliers about adaptation, which is time and energy consuming. The ICT deployment in government cannot be done overnight. And we cannot overthrow the original system again and again. We must improve the system continuously. Therefore, we have high requirements for stability and scalability. And Huawei Cloud Stack can help solve all these issues. And it is guaranteeing the in-depth digital transformation of governments and enterprises. By working with Huawei, we are now offering the smart government solution. At the bottom layer, we are leveraging Huawei Cloud Stack and cloud capabilities. And we now have the portal for services, one nowhere for management, and one screen for insights. And this is the all scenario applications which can guide the government to do the digital transformation. And the ultimate goal is to facilitate the digital transformation in all industries. And we also have one portal for government services. With Huawei Cloud, we now have features like cloudification that can reduce CAPEX, high scalability and high resource utilization, unified standards and easy system integration. In the future, system integration will be easier. And we also have integrated and continuous O&M to create values continuously. With the integrated O&M monitoring, we can manage the resources in a unified manner. And for different users, we can provide services anytime, anywhere, and on demand. We have solutions for each of the challenges I mentioned earlier. For the government service system, with the building of a unified platform, with cross-cloud application deployment, we can leverage the scalability of Huawei Cloud. And we can also deploy the SaaS internally so that we can respond to the increasing number of users. I will take the construction industry as an example. Normally, the number of users is stable, but when there is a major exam, the number of users is growing exponentially. If we do our planning based on the peak number, then resources will be wasted at normal times. To address this challenge, we can leverage the elastic and scalability capabilities of Huawei Cloud so that we can increase the capacity before the two major exams. And the geo-redundant DR solution has been explained to you by Mr. Gu Zhong just now. We can have real-time synchronization between the two data centers. When one breaks down, another center can come in and play. We also have redundant backup. If there is uncontrollable incident, our data assets will still be protected. If we only rely on governments or companies to implement the two-site, three-center solution, it will be costly. But with Huawei Cloud, we can break the one-time investments down into investments in multiple years. And this will reduce the financial pressure on the local governments and enterprises. And in adopting technologies from Chinese companies, we took detours in the past. In terms of adaptation, for example, the adaptation of databases to SQL language, the adaptation or compatibility of eSeals and so on. So compatibility and adaptation is one of the barriers in adopting the technologies from Chinese companies. But with this ecosystem, Huawei Cloud Stack will finish the adaptation ahead of time. And then we just need to choose the applications we want to satisfy our requirements. And by participating in this ecosystem and working with Huawei, we can contribute to the positive growth of this ecosystem. And we can also provide applications on the Huawei Cloud to participate in this ecosystem. Our solution is based on Huawei Cloud. So we have synchronization with zero waiting time. And with the Huawei Cloud, the industry partners can develop their business in depth in the industry and continue to evolve and be leading. Next, I want to share with you a case with the Hefei Public Resource Transaction Platform. Our customers have certain pain points in cloud migration, for example, insufficient staff and poor skills, inconvenient maintenance, and increasing system load as more buildings are moved online. So with the cloud, including e-government cloud, we have been able to solve these pain points. For example, we provide powerful underlying resource support through Huawei Cloud, and we have also been able to unify the data. And we have also been able to provide different levels of security. When the whole platform is launched, it covers 8 domains, 9 districts, and over 20,000 transaction entities. It is able to handle higher concurrency, improve user experience, enhance data security, and so on. Premier Li Keqiang visited the Hefei Public Resource Transaction Center, and he claimed that this center has achieved all transparent online. Over the years of cooperation with Huawei, our joint solution has been applied in different regions and industries and has been recognized by customers. This proves the in-depth technological and business cooperation between Huawei can achieve 1+1 is bigger than 2. In the coming years, we will continue to improve our current solution and serve more customers and provide them with more values. That's all for my sharing. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Yang. Huawei will work with our partners, join our forces together to provide the better services to our customers and users. So this session is wrapping up.